Hello, hello, and welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Julie, and in today's sewing tutorial, I'm going to make a backpack. The backpack closes with an elastic, what is really practical to get your stuff in and out. It also has two inside bags. And I made it from a curtain that I bought in a thrift store. I really love this flowery pattern on it, and I hope to make a handbag of it as well. I'm also going to sell this backpack. It's the first item that I ever sell. If you're interested, the Depop link is in the description. So the first thing I did was separate the actual curtain and the lining. I'm going to use this lining as the lining for the backpack. Then I cut two rectangles. A smaller one for the underside of the backpack from 20 centimeters on 28 centimeters or 7.8 inches on 11 inches. And a second, bigger rectangle for the body of your backpack. 98 on 40 centimeters or 38.5 inches on 15.5 inches. Be sure to pick a beautiful piece to draw this rectangle because this is going to be the main part of your backpack. Then I copied these pieces on the lining fabric to make the inside bag later. To unite these two pieces in love forever, take the body piece and mark 1 centimeter or 1/4 inch from each side and mark the middle of the smaller rectangle. Lay these markings together and pin your pieces in place. Be sure to leave the 1 centimeter you marked earlier unattached. This is to close the backpack later. Flip the little rectangle to the side and attach this. Keep flipping and sewing until the rectangle and the body are united forever. I'm not going to close the backpack yet because it's easier to install the straps with the backpack open. For the straps, I cut 2 more rectangles from 12 centimeters on 38 centimeters and 4.7 inches on 15 inches. Sew the two top sides over for a neat finish. Fold this double, right sides together, and sew this, but leave one piece open so you can turn this around. Next, cut a little square from 6 centimeters or 2.4 inches. Fold and sew the edges over. Fold the two ends to the middle and fold this double. Sew this. Now take a strap adjuster and slide this onto the top part of the strap adjuster. Put these straps into the opening at the main strap and sew them in place. Select the place where you want to attach the straps and pin those. To be sure that they won't come loose, I sewn them into a square pattern with an X in the middle. Then I made yet another strap. Making straps involves a lot of straps. I folded this strap double and I zigzagged around the edges until they were finished neatly. I did it this way because this strap can be too thick, otherwise it won't slide through the strap adjuster. Slide this strap into the strap adjuster and fold the loose end over so it cannot slide out of the strap adjuster. Finally, attach the strap to the end of the backpack with the same square pattern. Leaving the backpack open makes this process so much easier, but now it's time to close it up. Simply pin the backpack together and sew it. Then I cut and zigzagged around the edge to make it even. Okay, now we need a flap and a closing system and we're good to go. Lay your backpack flat and decide how big you want your flap to be. I chose 30 centimeters for mine. According to Google, this is 11.8 inches. I don't know who invented the inch system, but it's a little weirder. Go down 17 centimeters or 7 inches. Throw this into a flap shape that you like. Cut this out and copy it on another piece. Lay them right sides together and mark an opening at the top and a smaller one at the bottom. The one at the top is for turning around. The one at the bottom you will see later. Sew this using a straight stitch, but do not close the openings. Turn your flap around. Then I cut yet another strap from 12 centimeters on 2 centimeters. This is a little bit difficult because the strap has to be small. What you need to do is you need to fold the two ends to the middle, and then you need to fold this to the middle again. An ironer will make this process a lot easier. Sew this with a straight stitch as close to the edge as possible. Fold this strap double and slide it into the opening you created. Attach this by sewing. I sewn around the whole flap, just because I found that better. Now all what's left to do is to find a place where you want to install this strap, pin it and sew it. Okay, now you have a flap and a strap, but you also need something to close it, like a button. I found this cute square wooden button in the thrift store. I really love thrifting. Mark a spot where you want it to be and sew it on. And ta-da, you made a flap and a closing system. To make this bag more practical, I added an inside bag with bags in the sides. I copied these pieces in the beginning of the video and I'm going to set them together in the exact same way as I did with the backpack. Then I drew another rectangle from 20 centimeters on 14 centimeters or 7.8 centimeters on 5.5 inches. Cut this out and fold the top edge of your pocket over. Sew this in place. Then I made another meeting with my ironer to fold the other four edges over. Once this is done, I measured 15 centimeters down from the edge of my inside bag and I pinned the pocket in place. Then I sewn around it, make sure that you do not sew the upper edge or you will close the full pocket. And it will be useless, like some pockets in clothes. Like most pockets in women's clothing. Then I measured the half of the pocket and I sewn this as well, so I would make one pocket into two pockets. Then I closed the back. It's not really necessary to leave the back open for the pockets, but I did it anyway. And then I took another piece of the lining fabric from the curtain to copy the first back and to make a second one. I did not sew the second one in the middle, so the back has a big back and two little backs inside the inside back. A lot of back saying today. Now slide your inside back into your backpack. Pin up the edges and sew them in place. Fold around 10 centimeters of the edge of the backpack down. This will be very clear because this is where the flap is. And sew this, but very important, leave an opening because we're going to insert an elastic in this. Measure the elastic around your backpack. I made it 10 centimeters smaller than the backpack circle. Pin a safety pin to this and use the safety pin or hairpin to guide you through the loop. With do, I mean the elastic. Then I knotted the elastic together. I knotted it a few times. And then I made a little bit of fire, not to put this backpack or my house on fire, but just to burn off the edges of the elastic a little bit so they will not unravel. This is a very important step. And then all what is left to do is to close the opening and ta-da-da-da-da, your backpack is finished! Okay, that was it for this week's sewing tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you can support me and my channel by giving this video a big thumbs up and leaving a comment down below. This shows YouTube that you enjoy my video and hopefully they will show it to more people. If you wish to buy this backpack, it is for sale in the link down below. There's only one, so it's a unique piece and I will sell it on Depop. Okay, thank you. Bye. See you next time.